Good morning, you guys. It is a beautiful, sunny morning in Southwest Missouri, in the Missouri Ozarks. My chores are done for this morning, and I decided to come out to the garden areas and just kind of sit and admire and look around a little bit. We spend so much of our time raising our food, growing our food. This year, though, we've decided to plant some flowers and actually have some raised beds and some areas dedicated to flowers. And it's really been so enjoyable for me so far this year. Some of the flower plants are starting to put on their first flowers, and it's so exciting to kind of see a preview of what is to come this summer. I've realized that I've talked with you about our flowers, but I haven't really shown you what we've been doing. I haven't shown you any of the progress that some of these flowers have made. So this morning, I just want to take you around for a little bit of time to show you the progression of some of these flowers. I've really been enjoying these flowers more than I ever thought I would. We've been concentrating so hard the last 8 years on growing our food. It's really nice now to also incorporate some flowers onto the homestead. We will be using a lot of these flowers to sell at the farmer's market as cut flowers, but I'm so happy that I can also just have some around to enjoy. So let's go check out some of these flower gardens. This is my zinnia garden. I'm so excited for these guys. They're starting to bloom just a little bit, a flower here and there. They're getting so big. I planted these guys just from a little plug tray. So now that it's warming up, they're really starting to develop. A lot of them are putting out their little arms all around so they'll fill out and become kind of bushy. So I'm really happy about these guys. Their flowers are absolutely gorgeous. I think so far my favorite is the yellow. I planted these kind of randomly as far as colors go, just to have a nice variety once they start getting big and start producing. There's white, yellow, a couple different kinds of pink, orange, some of the short variety that stay really kind of short and compact, others that are big. I'm really happy about this. I'm excited to see what the summer holds for them. All of these zinnia seeds are from Baker Creek. I love Baker Creek. Up front here, we have a variety of marigold called spun orange, where the flowers themselves are supposed to get pretty big and actually on a stem that you can cut and use for a cut flower, unlike a lot of the other marigolds. And then in the back of the garden, I've planted pincushion flowers or scabiosa, and there's a mix of colors there, so I'm excited for them to start producing. So this is one dedicated flower garden, and I'm so excited to see how it's going to be in the middle of the summer. Next door to the zinnias are my cosmos. I planted three different kinds of cosmos this year, a white, a pink, and an orange. I didn't mix them up like I did the zinnias because I think they're going to be different heights. So I planted the white up front because I think they're going to be the shortest, and then the pink will be the next tallest, and then the orange will be the tallest in the back. So maybe it'll just be a nice progression of flower colors. And then in the front here, like I did over there by the zinnias, I put the spun orange marigolds followed by the scabiosa way in the back. I'm so excited. Look, some of the orange ones are starting to flower already. They are just gorgeous. When the sunlight hits them, they're almost like sunshine themselves. It's just amazing. We'll be using these also in cut flower arrangements for the farmer's market. And in the meantime, I'm getting so much enjoyment out of them. I don't think I've shown you guys this garden at all, this little raised bed garden. It's right next to the cosmos garden. This has been an herb garden for me the last couple of years, and I was hoping to transition it into a flower garden, but I'll tell you that these herbs just don't want to let go of this garden. It looks kind of crazy right now, right? It's like got just kind of, it looks like random stuff coming up all over the place. This was the primary bed that we planted dill, and it's from these dill plants that the dill has like wandered all the way around our property in the yard and the gardens. I actually found one way over in another garden that I have. I have no idea how dill got over there. Probably, you know, a bird seed. But my intention for this garden this year was to be sunflowers with nasturtium kind of pouring out the end, out the sides here. And I did plant the sunflower seeds and they are coming up. I planted like different levels as far as heights go so that the tallest will be in the center and then a couple different levels around the side with some nasturtium, which has come up and is growing, that will be gorgeous and trail out here and just be beautiful. This is another garden that used to be one of my herb gardens that I'm trying to transition into a flower garden. I love the shape of this. It's a triangle, which makes it kind of unique to us. All the rest of our raised beds are rectangles, so I really like this. But just like my other herb bed that I'm trying to transition into a flower bed, it's like the herbs just won't let go. The first year that I planted this, I planted comfrey in the middle. I had no idea how big comfrey would get, and so it like got gigantic and like took over everything. So the next year I dug it out but every year since then I still have comfrey coming up, which is fine. I've been transplanting it to a different location and on the homestead that it can just go berserk and it's fine. But I've already dug out a bunch of it this spring and now there's more for me to dig out. My hope for this garden overall and long term is for there to be kind of the specialty echinacea varieties in the middle and the borders be lined with an English lavender called Munstead lavender. So I have planted them around the perimeter of this garden. They're just growing slowly. And in the meantime, the like I said before, the herbs like are not letting go. The more I come out here to weed, actually the more volunteer plants I find yet from 2 years ago and from last year. So let me show you a little bit more up close what I'm talking about. Well, I forgot to mention again that I actually have like this most wonderful area over here of the Sweet William. They're actually on their way out, which makes me sad. But there's these white and pink, there's this brilliant scarlet red, and then this like fuchsia pink. They're so beautiful. But you can see that I've planted little lavenders every, I don't know, 18 inches, 24 inches or so. And that's around the perimeter of the garden, and I'm so excited about that. And I planted some echinaceas around here. There's one. But as you can see, like I was telling you, there's comfrey coming back. Also, to my surprise, these are little self-seeded zinnias. They are kind of coming up everywhere, which is a surprise. I'm going to let them go because I think that will be pretty. And this guy over here is a volunteer parsley plant. I can barely get parsley to germinate in the greenhouse and on a heat mat, let alone in the garden, and then this guy just shows up on its own. Don't get me wrong, guys. All of these are fantastic surprises. I'm gonna let them all go and just see what happens over here. I bet it's gonna be an awesome year in this garden. I think what is so special to me about all of this that's happening this year with the flowers and the herbs, my gosh, you guys, I have like a million herbs. I'm not ready to show you that yet. But the most special thing is that I've started them all from seed. So all of these flowers, hundreds and hundreds of plants, same with the herbs, they've all been started from seed. And I feel like that's a huge accomplishment. And I'm so happy about that. If I were to have to buy all of these as plant starts from a nursery or a big box store, we're talking probably thousands of dollars. Okay, maybe hundreds of dollars for sure. And I wouldn't have bought nearly as many plants as I have produced, really for just a few dollars each for as many plants as I could start from the seed packet. So I'm really so pleased and fortunate that it's been such a good year for starting flower seeds and herbs and, you know, our veggies too. It's just really amazing to see it all come together and work out. Now, this video, my intention with this video wasn't to be just like garden tours and stuff. I just wanted to share with you how excited I am about these flowers, but I'm also super excited with how far the summer garden has gotten in 1 week. I didn't think at all in 1 week you would be able to see a difference, but I just want to take you over to the summer garden. That's where we have our tomatoes, peppers, watermelon, cantaloupe, green beans, pinto beans, edamame, okra, that kind of stuff. Let's go over there, and I bet you're not even gonna believe how big everything is. The last time we showed you that garden, the seeds were just in the ground. They hadn't even sprouted. Like, literally, we had just put the seeds in the ground. And the tomato plants and the pepper plants had literally just come out of the pot, and we just stuck them in the ground. So let's go to the summer garden, and I'll just show you a quick tour. Well, look at these. That is the cantaloupe. Two rows of cantaloupe. Every single seed has germinated. Amazing. Amazing! Next up, watermelon seeds germinated up out of the ground. Next up, these pinto beans are crazy, you guys. These are the tiger rye pinto beans. They're so far out of the ground. Like, they don't even have first leaves anymore. They've got like their first set of their big bean leaves. So, pinto beans, green beans, more green beans, okra. I thought they wouldn't germinate, so I put two in each hole, and they all germinated. And way down there are the transplants we put in. Next up, peppers. Look at these guys. They look fantastic. More peppers. It's like they've tripled in size in a week. Craziness. On to the tomatoes. Do you remember the spindly little lanky tomatoes that we planted just a week ago? These guys are the jet stars and the jet setters, our big slicers and stuff. Next door, these guys, they're doing okay. I wish I were more proud. These are the paste tomatoes. It looks like they're struggling a little bit more. And honestly, there are five of them we need to replant because they must have gotten a little bit too dry. Are the cherry tomatoes and the experimental row. These guys are just doing crazy. Just going bonkers. Now, remember, the tiny little spindly lanky plants we put in there. Now, I'm not saying they were bad. I knew they would do well, but I cannot believe how well these guys are doing in just 1 week. Craziness. Over here, edamame. Coming out. So exciting. Now this side of the edamame row, not doing so great. These are our cucumbers. We planted them from starts, which we normally don't do. And first off, they've gotten a lot of bug bites, like from flea beetles, but a couple of them actually just like bent over and are like dying. So we need to replace those and or just stick some seeds in the ground. So out of all that, we'll take these as not doing as well. But seriously, guys, can you even believe it? I can't even believe it. This is such a blessing. It's so amazing. If this is how 1 week is going to be, can you imagine how the entire summer is going to be? Hopefully the weather is wonderful and everything is hunky-dory and we get great, great harvests from the summer garden. Well, that's not it, you guys. We've got one big flower garden project that hasn't even been started yet. So we're going to work on that today. I'm so excited to bring you along, not only today, but the rest of the summer and even next year, because it'll be better, even better next year. So I'm going to go get changed and meet Kevin out into that other area, and we're going to get started on another big project. Well, this is going to be perfect back here, you guys. I'm so excited. This is gonna be an entirely new garden for us, a cottage garden, just gonna be filled with beautiful flowers. Last summer, Kevin built us an outdoor shower. You can see it back there, behind that rusty metal, which I absolutely am in love with, that rustic look. Inside there is a shower area, and then the water comes down from a big black trash can up there, comes down through the tubing and out the faucet, and we can shower there after a hot, sticky day. It'll be just really refreshing. After he made that, though, I thought, gosh, wouldn't it be wonderful if we could make this into just a beautiful flower garden area that we could come out and relax and just have some peace and quiet amongst the flowers. So over the winter, I started working and dreaming of a cottage garden for out here. A cottage garden is really just a fancy term for a beautiful flower garden that you can just kind of go and sit and relax and appreciate the beauty of the flowers. So I'm excited to get started on that. Now that our summer garden is all planted, I can focus some of my attention and energy into just making a really beautiful area over here. Kevin brought over the tractor yesterday and tilled up this area. Since we have a tiller attachment on our tractor, we might as well use it, because this was like a 10-minute job, whereas with the push tiller, it would have been hours of work. But so that I don't need to battle weeds in this area this summer, and really any summer coming up, we're actually gonna fill this area with the black woven weed fabric that we absolutely love. We're gonna put that down, and then we'll put holes through it, and I'll plant the flowers through the holes. Most of what I'm planting here this year are gonna be perennials, which is awesome. Kind of one time and you're done. There will be a few annuals, but I'm really excited to get started on this project. To secure the woven weed fabric to the ground, we use these 6-inch landscaping staples. For the most part, they've done really well for us. We did have some problems in our summer garden during a big storm, but otherwise, these work really well. So we have the black woven fabric all over where the garden is going to be. We have it in the walkway where we're going to go into the shower. You know, I'm going to be planting mostly, at least at first, around the perimeter here. But on the inside here, we'll have mulch down, like wood chips and stuff. We'll cover all of this black plastic area, and it'll just look nice. The next step, though, is a privacy fence. So we're going to be putting a fence right along this edge, almost the entire way, and I'm going to plant hyacinth bean, which will grow up the fencing and will give us some extra privacy, because the road is kind of that direction and we want privacy from the road. But on this side over here will be the entrance, and we're going to have an archway here that I'll also grow some vines up. So I'm hoping that'll look really pretty. So gosh, I'm so excited to get started on this. And now that the black woven plastic, the woven ground cover is down, once we get the fencing up, I can just start planting. I know that because a lot of these flowers are perennials, they'll probably take a couple years to get nice and big and full, and they might not even flower this year, but it will be a nice work in progress. And I'm excited to show you guys when it's all done, and I'm sure I'll give you updates along the way.
So we're gonna start by building our archway before we put up the fence. We're gonna be building the archway out of a 16-foot cattle panel. The cattle panels are 52 inches wide, so I'm putting two T-posts 3 feet apart. Then we'll arch the cattle panel over and mark the other side where we want it, and then we'll put the other T-posts in on the other side to hold it in place. Pretty simple process, and we're just gonna get it going, so that way we'll know where we wanna run our fence line, because we don't want the cattle panel completely inside or completely outside of the garden area. We want it kind of halfway along the fence line.
You might not be able to see it, but we do have our cattle panel laying flat on the ground. And now we just need to bend it up in the middle and bring it, you know, close to the T-post. This part can be a little bit scary and nerve-wracking because it can easily like flip out underneath you. So we just have to be slow and be careful. Well, you guys, this is the beginning of something wonderful. I cannot believe that we are this far along in this project. Now, all I have to do is start planting. So on this fence here, I'm going to be growing hyacinth bean, and I will plant it close together so that it grows up and creates a screen here. It's going to be beautiful. Down below here, we left quite a bit of space in order for us to get the fence high enough for privacy. So we're gonna run some wire along the bottom, a couple levels of wire, so that the hyacinth bean has something to grab onto so it can start climbing up here. And when it gets to the top, you guys, it's actually gonna continue kind of growing up. It might flop over a little bit or something like that. But this will provide us with a lot of privacy. Those are the first things that I am going to be planting, are these hyacinth beans. And then I have another vining plant. I don't remember what it's called, like butterfly pea or something like that. But I'm going to plant that here. It's going to be beautiful. So we'll have gorgeous like magenta purple flowers over here from the hyacinth beans. And then these are like a brilliant cobalt blue flower. It's just going to be gorgeous. I can't wait. I am excited for you guys to come along as I continue planting and as they grow up and as we develop this area back here. It's really a nice kind of getaway, beautiful place to just sit and relax, either before or after a shower. It's just going to be a nice, peaceful place. I'm super excited. So you guys, if you are enjoying our videos, if you enjoyed our projects that we're working on, make sure you hit the subscribe button so that you can join us every time. If you know somebody else who would also enjoy what we're doing here and the lifestyle that we're living, we would love for you to share it with them so they can be a part of our community as well. Until next time, you guys, thank you so much for stopping by the homestead. Take care and God bless.